Hello, guys and gals. Chartreuse here, and welcome to the World of Madness. Yes, the World of Madness server. I'm on a server, again, with people. It is fun. And let's turn off the cinematic camera, otherwise it's going to drive us crazy. So, today, first episode. You may notice I have absolutely nothing, and I usually prepare for things like this. Well, not today. Because of Outpost Bravo, which we will never mention again after we visit it today. So, with a bit of carrots that we harvested beforehand, we now wander off in search of our outposts and let you guys know what's about to happen here. So, the World of Madness server. It is a private server running... What is it? It's a vanilla server, but it's got a bunch of command block modules on it. Lots of weird things like player head drops and stuff like that. Desire lines like that. Which leaves paths where you've walked before. You might be able to see some from the previous run of this I did, because I've run back and forth many times here. There's some weird crafting recipes, some cool, pretty cool things that I look forward to experimenting into when I get done. Anyways, my goal for this... Well, actually, let's tell you who's on here. So the server members right now are myself, Drad from Drad's World LP, Ferris Blinitech, however they say that channel. They'll all be in the description down below. Gladric, Lying in Bedmon, Mark, Makashi, Sneaky Magoo, Sofa7, the 8-Bit Monkey, and Topstagear. So, this server, it's... one thing about it is it's the server's courtesy of Ready2Frag Hosting, if you look down below. So this is semi-sponsored. The server is sponsored by them, it's paid for them, but... So that's why that code's down there. You can look down there. We have a 15% lifetime discount with them. I'm not personally getting paid by them. It's just the servers. So here we will. And here we are coming out to Outpost Alpha. This first little section where I started off, my first mine. Not really named or anything. I believe I have some furnaces down at the bottom. Nothing too exciting here. Now the goal is to find Outpost Bravo. Outpost Bravo is kind of weird. It's out. It's a bit farther out. It's in the middle of a clearing that I barely got. I dug a hole straight down three blocks and put a block above me just as a creeper just about fell into there. That is my second outpost, and I at that point I had quite a good chunk of iron, lots and lots of gold and lapis, and a diamond pickaxe. You can see I do not have that stuff. What happened was I was caving in, abandoned mine. I was in an abandoned mine shaft, and I got ambushed by the new skeletons, which are absolutely brutal. The arrows cut right through iron armor like you're wearing nothing. So I died. My undead player, the zombie, picked up my stuff. Got there a second time, killed by the skeletons again. Third time, the undead players were still alive. I ended up getting down there. I saw it. I couldn't find anything on the ground because I had tunneled. That time I tunneled basically straight down onto where I thought I'd onto where the coordinates where I died. But nope, the stuff was gone. And when I tried to go and get the undead player that was holding my at least the diamond pickaxe, it seemed to have disappeared. It fell and it got knocked to lava by a creeper blast or some such annoying thing. It's kind of unfortunate, so basically lost everything, rage quit for quite a few days, And now we're here, trying to find Outpost Bravo, because I did drop a lot of the stuff in the chest at the top of the outpost. Now, it's not really anything more than a hole in the ground, but we are trying to find it. I'm looking for a plains over somewhere in this vicinity. I believe I walked around the left of this mountain here. I have no coordinates for it. I don't know anywhere. I don't have a really good idea where it is, but we are looking for it. Now, if you excuse me, I'm just going to check something here. Yeah, I'm looking. We have lots of weird crafting abilities. We can get we can actually get any mob spawners we want. It just takes a lot of mob heads, which take our rare drop, and then make a lot of weird things like that. Plus bells, decorative blocks, way too many stuff that it's going to take me forever to learn about. On a nice mod, that means one person can sleep and then everyone can allow it, or they can click and say, no, I'm not going to allow. I don't want you to set it today. So that's kind of a nice feature. So what are my plans with this series? Well, I think I'm going to be trying to do it a lot like my failed single-player series, besides just playing with the guys. We are going to have fun, play build, do redstone, and also we're going to try and build gigantic things. Now, an architecture style that I really like is brutalism. You might know it if you think of the large concrete exterior only buildings, lots of fairly angular shapes and repeating patterns and such. Yeah, that type of construction. We're going to try and build some pretty massive buildings, imposing buildings. That looks like the right way. So one thing we're going to do when we get to this outpost here, we're going to turn it into something proper and put a little marker on top of it so we know where it is. And we are going to continue on and go to make our outpost Charlie. That is a plains there. I think that's it. And my dog is bothering me. So let us get to Outpost Bravo. Should be in this plains biome right here. I believe, hopefully, I put a cobblestone block above my head, not a dirt block. Otherwise, we are going to be pretty lost, and it is turning night. Well, that's about what happened last time. I believe I was over on this hill here. And, this is going to be close, and I don't have a pickaxe, so if we find the cobble block, yes, here it is. This is Outpost Bravo. Oh, it's going to take a bit of damage. Let's drop in. And here we are. Outpost Bravo. We have Top Stickier's head. Yeah, we got still a fairly decent amount of stuff left. And down there leads to where we died. See you in a second. And welcome back. As you can probably hear, it's still nighttime out. Apparently I'm pretty poor at my timing. We're going to wait a bit before we leave. Just getting some more things out of our caving expedition. I went back down to the dangerous mines and got us a few more bits of iron and a like gold, lapis. Got enough diamonds now to make another diamond pick and try and get an enchanting table. Something that we really need next time we surface is to try and get some wool for some sheep. We should make some shears for that. Just grab that quick. Otherwise, we're going to obviously forget that. Shears. Because when we can make a bed, we don't have to deal with this. That. Also, always keep smelting up smooth stone. With the building style I'm going for, smooth stone is going to play a big part in it. It's going to be pretty exclusive to smooth stone. Though, I think today, when we're going to go exploring, we're going to try and find a suitable hillside for Outpost Charlie. I have a plan for it. I think I'm going to build it out of potentially cobble for. Mostly cobble first, because smooth stone is pretty expensive right now. It costs one piece is an eighth of a coal block. So each coal piece of coal we get is 8 blocks. Anyway, this is gonna take a while. Yeah, I think it is. Guess we have a little mob grinder here. That's not particularly what I wanted in my mob grinder. Just walking in here. How many mobs are on the surface? Jesus, I'm going on. You see this big opening here? That caused by one of these guys. Yeah. We'll probably expand it a little bit. Anyway, I'll join you guys when it is daytime. Okay, and welcome back. It looks like it's just turning day, so we're going to try and grab what we need and get out of here. This is going to be a really annoying inventory. We're going to leave some stuff back here. We're going to come back for it, but we want our wood. Try and get all our coal. What crud in here do we not need right now? I think that we need the arrows. The bones can stay here. We'll come back for them. What do we not really care about? Don't need all the lapis right now. It just takes up extra space. Take the iron. All the probably should leave some iron here back here as a safety measure. Yeah, that's probably good. No, that's useless. Yeah. Okay. Oh, good space. Let's take the lapis and the apple. Redstone. Let's try to stay here for now. Okay. Make note of our coordinates. In the easy way. We're gonna surface really fast here. There's probably a creeper on us. Nope. No creepers here. Spider's not aggroed. Maybe. We're gonna kill it anyway. And it's gonna hit us anyway. Okay, actually, that doesn't look too bad. We wanna go east. Yeah, east is. Oh, okay. This looks so familiar. I guess it's not. We're gonna head east. We can ignore all these great chickens, these source of feathers, and the. I guess we shouldn't have taken all that crap. Got one space left. Let's get our reeds here. Those are gonna be useful. Now, I'm not sure how many times other people are going to be on this server, but well, most people seem to be in the UK, and me being here in Canada, this time zones don't quite line up with best times, but we'll see. That hill there is looking promising for Outpost Charlie. Well, it's a bit close for my taste. Thinking about it. Because I'm looking for a hillside, because I do have an idea for this. I feel like I'm gliding. Maybe I should turn view bobbing back on. That way, I don't know what you guys like. If you like the view bobbing or just the smoothness. But we are going to continue until we find what looks like a pretty nice hill. I want a slope, though. I don't want it perfectly flat because otherwise my thing stands out like a sore thumb when I'm going to build. It's such a nice plains here. I feel something quite big can be built in this little valley here. Yeah. So, if we don't find something shortly, I'll see you guys when we find Outpost Charlie. We're artists. Actually, I think that looks like a pretty good thing, even though we're not that much. We're not too much farther out. We're going a bit south here. We're trying to go east. So the sun's rising. Yeah. It looks like it was getting dark over there. This hill might just be tall enough for what I want. Might. Not sure if it is. I think that one might actually be a better candidate. But I don't like the stone on it because I'm going to be putting stone. I want a big contrast. We'll see. I don't like this torch in my left hand, but it's being an extra storage spot right now. Horses. I had saddles. Had name tags. Had a few records. Up was Charlie. Better be better than Outpost Bravo in that regard. And this ocean looks like that hill there might be our choice. The big mountain there. Right by Outpost Bravo. Yeah. Crying out loud. I just don't know if this is steep enough. It's not really big enough of a hill, this thing here, for my project. It's gonna have to be the mountain, I think. Just kind of hoping there'd be an extreme hills biome or something just nearby. Let's take a look what's over here. Sorry about the clicks. And welcome back. I think I have found our ideal hill here. Well, it could be a little taller, but I think we are going to build Outpost Charlie onto this hill here. It seems to be the candidate. It's nice, fairly linear slope. We are going to be building our own extension. Just have to chop down a few trees. It's quite a decent height to it. Yeah, so we are going to prepare by clearing out a bit of a wooded area here. And with that, we will be able to start on our build. A lot of cuts this episode. See you guys in a second. And welcome to nighttime, because apparently you forgot to try and find a sheep, or I didn't see any. I'm just away from where I've decided Outpost Charlie is, but it's there. I also believe that's a creeper up on that little floating island up there. That's kind of cool. Anyway, we're just going to have to wait out a night again. Not sure what to do here. I think I'll just, ow. Oh, baby zombie. Where's the baby zombie? Must be in a cave. I think we are just going to wait it out and see you guys when we're ready to go. Oh, there's a little bugger. There's the little bugger. Get the axe out. Ow. Get some iron armor back again. This thing's hurt. I think we are going to dig in here for the night. See you guys when morning comes. And welcome back, and there is a creeper trying to kill us. Doing a poor job of it. And we're going to blitz out in case there's another one above us. Nope, we're fine. We have wasted a few minutes being a bit late because I was too busy looking at the Canadian election results just to date the content. So yeah, we hit up in a hole last night because we haven't seen a single sheep yet. That might be more important than our outpost because spending 10 minutes doing nothing between cuts isn't too fun. But hey. So let's get rid of all these saplings that were auto planted by the trees. I said we'll get rid of these. Crap, we have too much garbage in our inventory again. Not these. Throw through a few signs down here just to store them until I get a chest made. We don't want these trees getting replanted as a problem. Alright. That'll probably do. So our goal is kind of a triangular build. We want it's going to be a thing going up the hill, and then roughly in the middle, signs are going to come out, overhang quite a bit, and go back towards it as a centerpiece. Now, the problem I have is going to be scale. We're not really sure what I'm going to want here. So I'm thinking I'm going to center it roughly on this cave. So we're going to go here. Let's say that's the top. We're going to expand out so we're above. Well, this is quite nice. It's quite handy. Oops. Pick it out our way. We'd rough it in cobble first. Get out of here. Let's see how that line look. Yeah, I think that's right, roughly the right angle. So down to here. So now I think we're gonna extend that out. Yeah, about that much more. Two more on each, I think. And we're gonna right-click and place torches. A lot, because I'm not used to this this left-hand stuff. Nor am I apparently good at placing blocks. This is so annoying. It's gonna be so annoying. Just wonder if that's enough. Yeah, I think that's enough to make a state. We'll see. And then we're gonna need it to be. Ooh. How tall is this? Might want to proportion this like a golden ratio or something. So we got. So we're at level 64. Apologize for the spacebar tapping. You're probably gonna hear that because I'm not using my soft keyboard. So level 64 to 78. So we got 14 high. So your Fibonacci number is 8 and 13. 8 wide? That might be a bit too much. Yeah, actually, 8 wide might be right. So 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 1 too high. Yeah. How wide? It's kind of narrow, actually. So that was a weird sound. We are going to make it one wider, or two. Two wider so we have a double door. So, I don't know why I put that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we do have an 8 gap in the middle. So that's what I'm gonna use as the reasoning on that. But it's close enough. And they're all approximations, just what looks good. You have to do a lot of clearing though, it seems. So this is one above that, so we need to build this up one higher. And that is the first layer. And we are going to need to clear a bit more dirt for this side. I think I might actually extend this one further out just to get a bit more depth to this. Yeah, because this is... I don't know if it's far enough. It's not far enough out on this side is the problem. So, let's just finish building up this frame, and then we'll see what we're going to do from there. While the pigs try and bother us by doing stuff like that. This right-handed thing is, our left-hand thing is so odd. I am at the right. These are being aligned all right up, right? So we're at 73 high on this side. 73 high on that side. Perfect. Okay, so we are doing it right. So this uneven hill is actually kind of messing with our symmetry. We're doing three steps on each one of the other one, but we're having to do them quite a bit more here. Ow. So let us take a look at our product here. That's kind of narrow, but I guess that's kind of the idea with it. It's gonna sort of work. I just don't know if we're building it grandiose and big enough. And I'm looking at that sun, and that's probably going to cut our episode short. So yeah. We're going to build out just a little further here. Build out to this level. This will be the top structure. Do we want it to flush? No, it's going to be... It's got to go up a bit. Trying to just build it up one more here. This needs to stand out just above the landscape. We're gonna give ourselves some fins, a little fin in the back. We might make a little tower with this. And I swear I keep hearing a creeper fall. Let me know if you're hearing that too, if that's just me, just in my head there. please don't be just in my head. Okay, so we are lining up. Everything looks like it's lining up well. I think we are going to expand this out just one more level before night falls. And just remember that we're going to have to come back and replace this all with probably smooth stone, or I might decide. There's got to be a cave below us. This sounds. I heard a zombie that time. Where'd you come from? All right. Oh, that's annoying. Can't really do that while you're. That's just frustrating. And we're going to quickly do this off, and we are going to be back after the night yet again. Oh yeah, that's looking pretty good. Get our overhang started next time. Oh, sun, nighttime. What is that creeper noise? Let's go back to our little hole in the ground. And we'll see you guys tomorrow. The same episode, probably. This has not gone on ridiculously long. If not, we'll see you guys next time. Bye. All right, another day, another bit of building. Everything's up. Fuck, we're dead. Called that. That was dumb. I break the top block by accident, and now I have to go find out where that is. Okay, respawn. Homebred missing up. Whatever, I'm gonna spawn anyway. One second while I look at my screenshot of where I just was. We were quite a bit to the east. I know roughly the direction. And besides the zombie, which we're gonna have to make a axe probably quickly to take care of. Actually, probably stone sword's better, I think. So we are heading off roughly 1700, I think. Yeah, we're 1620 by 655, which is way over that way, I think. Yep. We are going to borrow some materials from the chests back here just to make a stone. Yeah, probably just a stone sword's enough to take off that zombie. Even though he has iron. Sorry, I'm going to borrow your stone here. Uh-oh. Guess I'll repay it later. Nope, nope, help myself. This will be fine. I'll probably put some back there at some other time. Wood, I need a stick. At least I don't have a stick. Can I have a stick? Can I have a stick? I'm going to borrow a piece of wood. Make us some sticks. And what causes more attack damage? A pick or an axe at stone level? 8 attack. Or not pick, what am I doing? 5 attack, okay, we're going to make an axe. That should be help us take on the zombie faster. And we are off. Oh, well, before we're off, we're going to take a carrot. Carrots, because we're going to run out of food. Okay, we're off. 7 carrots to our name. Go and try to find Outpost Charlie. About 1,600 blocks this way. This nice pond here I've never seen, never saw before. Onward! Alright, we're back. It looks like we got everything, so I think our ended player zombie burned up in the daylight when we ran here. We have to make a quick stop at Outpost Bravo. Apparently my sword's way over here. Ugh. Stuff in my inventory. The wrong button to go. Checking if I missed anything. Some cobble over here. Some block of cobble. Interesting. Yeah, the saplings. Over the cobble, threw down. Yeah, I think. There. And, just for the fun of it, it's night again. So our goal is to find one sheep to kill. Didn't have shears on me, so I had to kill the two I saw, which now we do have shears. I keep hearing creeper noises. What is that? Anyway, I think we are probably going to have to end our episode here. It's gone on quite a long time, it seems. At least for me, it has. So, stay tuned. Next time, we will finish up our house. We will find a sheep so we can stop worrying about the night and having all these cuts everywhere. And yeah, see you guys next time. Bye.